a lot of people who even do a lot of exercise. So anyone who's doing a lot of sitting, driving, spending a lot of time on their butt, which is a lot of people these days, this is for you. So first of all, a modified down dog. So we'll get Margaret here to take this as if we're half down dog. Now, as you'll notice, Margaret's got no problems with her back. So she's got ample flexibility. So I should get somebody out of the audience here to come and do this demo. But so this is how they would normally look. They could be very tight through here. So what we want to do is we're going to address it by bending the knees. But the main thing is tilt. So we've got to really, really sit bones up and push the pubic bone under. And then you can work on the rest of the body. So you're bending the knees as much as you need to, staying with that tilt. So the main thing is just think about drawing the sit bones up. And then we'll get Margaret to come on up. So from a beginner's point, we'll bring the hands one at a time back to the hips and lift up. Good, keeping that nice spine. So we're going to, with Margaret, demonstrate that pelvic tilt for you from there. So we're going to take it and exaggerate it the opposite way. So this is to flatten the back, which you don't want, and you can see it rounds through the back, which we don't want. And then if we ask to tilt, you'll notice the chest comes up, the lumbar goes in, and you're halfway to having a good posture. If nothing else, she's going to draw attention to herself. So we'll get her to do it again with that same tilt in mind. So you can go back down and see how far you can go down this time. Same tilt. And then lengthen. Good. So take your legs back now as far as you need to for downward facing dog. So you go down. That's it. So to modify this, we'll ask Margaret to think she's very tight again. And come up high on her toes. Pressure off the hamstring in the lower back, and then with that same tilt that she had before, push back and bend forward, okay. Keeping the knee soft, and then you can walk down the leg towards the chair. Lovely. So main action is through the tilt again. If you haven't got this capacity to bend from the hips here, then you can stay up as high as you need to. Some of you may look more like this, and that's perfectly okay with that knee soft. Try and keep the toe in line for the moment, and then we're going to get her to come up, keep her knee soft, and lift and straighten the leg. Bend it, straighten it, bend it, straighten it. So for beginners, you might be down here, straightening, straightening. Good. And let's change the legs over. So the first one's always practice, the second time round, know exactly where you're going. Soft knee, tilt in those pelvis, sit bones, and soft knee, soft knee, soft knee, coming down, 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 or staying where you stay. Obviously you can't go where you can't go. Good. Trying to push the chest through, lift up through here. Now it could be both knees well bent if need be for somebody who's really beginning. Good. And then lengthen to come up. Stay with that knee soft. Hinge a little and lift the leg and straighten it. Bend. Lift the leg and straighten it. Bend. One more time. Lift and bend. Good. And bring the leg off and bring it down. A little shake. So we'll get Margaret to sit on the chair. Sit on the buttocks there. Sit right on the edge of the chair and put the block in the second position to make sure that she's got her feet underneath the knees. She's going to squeeze the block with the inner thighs. Squeeze that action, I'm going to ask her to stand up. So she's squeezing, and she's just going to stand up using the arms for beginners. Coming down, pressing the buttocks back, pressing to come back up, squeezing through with the block, back down. You've got nice long legs, that's a lower squat for you. Great. A couple more, engaging through the inner thighs, butt, and the quad. Last time, stay down. Great. And we'll now take that out, get her to use her hands. She's actually going to do an isometric squeeze. So you're going to press the knees in as you push the arms. Body will let you know whether you can hinge forward and how far you can hinge. You might be able to come all the way forward and drape onto that front thigh, sticking the butt back. And again, believe me, you've got limited abilities in this one, you'll know it, you won't get that far, it'll be quite excruciating. You're working a lot of movement in that ball and socket, so just breathe into it. Don't be pushing yourself beyond your limits and work with your body day to day. Bring that up, change legs, and come out the way you went in. Engage the abdominals, pull up. Lovely. Changing legs, up and over. Action. And when you're in these movements, you're working two sides. So you want to make sure that you're acknowledging the difference between the two sides. Great. Lovely. And a little bit tighter on this side. So then you go forward again to your level. Remember, you always want to stay on the side of any discomfort and pain. Days of no pain, no gain, completely gone, they're no longer in. You like to think we're working a little bit more intelligently these days, honouring the body, the vessel that it is, but the years that you want it to be working with you. Lovely. Inhale and come back up. We're going to do a full forward bend, so I'm going to take the knees a little wider apart. Keep the feet pointing in the same direction as the knees are going. You tilt forward and you come down on your elbows to start. And then you address what level you can go from there. Maybe you can go to the floor. Maybe you can go all the way through. Again, you want to make sure that the back is as flat as possible. For some people, you may need to bring the floor up and use a block or two in front of you. And you want to make sure the knees are not going too much wider than the actual body. So you want to keep them inside the line of the body. Good. And then if you can go all the way through, some people, if they're very flexible, will have their hands around and they'll be taking hands on the back here. That's an advanced movement. When you're down there, it's always a good time to make sure nobody's stuck their chewing gum under the seat. Good. Gently come out the way you went in. level two, you might be able to put your elbow down. Level three, but be able to bring prayer into it and hold. Prayer into it, make sure the buttocks stay down. Beautiful twist for your internal organ, for the spine, make sure the buttocks stay anchored. The breath is solid, just holding the breath. And there's as much projection forward as it is turning. About the top side coming back, the underside going under. Great. And then make sure you come up the same way you went in. Inhale up. And bring your hands back. We'll go back up to the other side. Nice big long reach that lengthens the spine. Exhale down onto that other side. Level one, remember, just the hand, maybe grouping together. Twisting the tilt torso, keeping the base nice and anchored. Those beautiful poses again that you can do in your office seating. Allow that sensation of breathing in to bring you out and then come back up the way you went. And then we'll finish with the hands on the back of the chair trying to do a chest open. Okay. So the more you can sit right on the edge of the chair, reach the arms back, maybe you can get the fingers to touch along the back of the chair.
I've got to work at 2:30 anyway.